Stanley goes camping.
Stanley Lamb-Chop lived with his mother, his father, and his little brother Arthur.
Stanley was 4 feet tall, about a foot wide, and half an inch thick. He had been flat ever since a molten bird fell on him.
There were lots of good things about being flat. Stanley could put on sunscreen in one swat.
Stanley had the best back float at the pool.
Stanley had the loudest belly flop too.
But sometimes it was hard being the only flat kid in town.
Loser. I'm sick of being flat, said Stanley one morning.
Flat is lame.
Lame, said Miss Lamb-Chop.
Why, some of the best things in the world are flat.
Like the newspaper, said Mr. Lamb-Chop.
And fried eggs, and pancakes, and bacon, said Arthur.
I guess so, said Stanley.
After breakfast, Mr. Lamb-Chop started loading up the car with tents and sleeping bags.
What's going on? Asked Arthur.
We're going camping, said Miss Lamb-Chop. This family needs some fresh air.
All right, yelled Arthur.
Stanley barely smiled.
After a short drive, the Lamb-Chops arrived at the Roaring River campground. Stanley was helpful as usual. He helped carry firewood.
But Stanley just wasn't himself. He wouldn't even eat any s'mores.
Too flat, he muttered.
Why don't you two go exploring? Suggested Mr. Lamb-Chop.
Good idea, said Miss Lamb-Chop. Just don't get lost or fall off a cliff or touch any poison ivy.
Have fun, Billy and Arthur said out.
Hey, animal tracks, said Arthur.
Let's follow them. The boys followed the tracks along the river through some trees and up a steep hill with a cliff on one side.
The tracks ain't here, said Arthur.
He peered over the cliff.
I wonder what kind of animal made them.
Arthur, said Stanley. Arthur turned around.
Skunk, he whispered. Let's get out of here. But the boys were trapped. The skunk was on one side. The cliff was on the other.
Then the skunk raised its tail.
What do we do? Arthur wailed.
Mom said not to fall off a cliff, said Stanley. She didn't say not to jump off.
Suddenly, Stanley grabbed Arthur by both hands and jumped.
Ah! Arthur screamed.
Then Arthur opened his eyes. He wasn't falling. He was sailing above him. Stanley's body made the perfect parachute. The boys landed with a gentle plop.
That was awesome, said Arthur.
Thanks, said Stanley. Now where are we?
Arthur and Stanley looked around.
All they saw were trees.
We're lost, said Arthur.
And it's getting dark.
And Stanley spotted something.
There's the river, he said.
Our campground is on the river.
The boys ran to the water's edge. About a mile downstream were two cozy Lamb-Chop tents.
What can we do?
It will be dark before we can walk that far, said Arthur.
I know, said Stanley. Stanley got a running start and barely flopped into the river.
Splash! Then he flipped over onto his back.
Climb on!
Woohoo! Cried Arthur. I always wanted to go rafting.
Arthur and Stanley made it back to camp dripping but safe.
Let's keep this to ourselves, said Stanley. I can't believe we got lost and went off a cliff, Arthur said. At least we didn't touch poison ivy.
There you are, said Miss Lamb-Chop, just in time for supper.
That night, Arthur whispered to Stanley from a sleeping bag.
You know, if you weren't flat, you couldn't have saved us today, Stanley smiled.
Maybe being flat isn't so lame, he said.
And the next day, Stanley found out another good thing about being flat.
Loser.
He could put on poison ivy cream in one swipe.
Total loser. these walls are the stories that I can't explain. I leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones. Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone.